Hey there everybody, this is Morris with a quick Adobe Creative Cloud tip for you. And today we're going to talk about how to get a handwritten signature into Adobe Illustrator natively as a piece of vector art. And there's a few steps to it. And so I decided to try to use Adobe Shape. And if you don't know what Adobe Shape is, it comes with your Adobe Creative Cloud membership and it allows you to take photos with your mobile device. It will look at the contrast lines within that image and create vector artwork out of that. So let's go ahead and get started. You start by launching Adobe Shape once you download it. And the first thing you'll notice is going to tell you to switch to Adobe Capture CC. This is a very new development, and if you had it months ago and you never got around to it, I thought I'd just show you all that. And you go ahead and launch Adobe Capture CC. But I'm over here in Adobe Shapes right now. You hit the plus sign. Here is my signature that I've written rather sloppily, I must say. And if you want to capture something that is in written form, the best thing to do is go with a Marks-A-Lot or a Sharpie. I'm a Sharpie guy myself. I like that way they smell. They give you a little bit of the high there. And that can't be all bad. And you write it on a high contrast piece of paper, so a white, in this case it's a green piece of paper, but still there's plenty of contrast, and that is the key to creating vector here. If there are these green highlights over whatever it is you're trying to capture, then you're in a good place. And it went ahead and captured it. Now the next thing you'll notice are there are these two lines right here. By default, you have this thing on the right selected that says remove from shape. You simply get your fingertip and you rub it across and it will delete those from your final image. You'll see that it's not completely perfect. It has not converted it to a vector art yet, and you're about to see it do its job. Okay, it is doing its thing now, and you hit next again. And I'm gonna write signature. And we're going to go ahead and save this into my CC shape files. And now we're just going to hop over into Illustrator and do some finishing touches on this. So here in Adobe Illustrator, if you go to Window and Libraries, okay, and you will see it right there in the in Libraries under My Shape CC Files. If you don't see it there, it could be because you saved it in a different place. I have a folder also called My Library. So you just simply drag it over in. I already have a document created. I'm going to size it up, put it in there. Okay. And you'll notice it comes in as a group because you have your dots here. I have my B that's not connected in any way to the rest of my signature here. And you'll notice that it's not entirely perfect. You've got these little artifacts. See that right there? And Shape just does not pick up every little detail. And so you have to go in there. And we're going to go in here and do what we can. The other thing you'll notice is, let me move this out a little further, is that our main signature elements are compound shape. And if you know anything about compound shapes, you know that you can release a compound shape. So let's go over here and go to Object, Compound Path, and release it. And you notice it filled in all of our holes, and that's okay. So we have these little artifacts. Let's go ahead and start by getting rid of them. We want to keep that because that's the circle on my O there. And there's part of my S. But see, I've got these little artifacts right here that I want to get rid of. And also, if you don't like the shape of the S, like this part of the S here, kind of, when it captured it, it sort of tips up like a shark fin. It just looks a little odd to me. And so, you know, you can go into things like this and just kind of mess with it. And if you want it to look a little bit better. Nope, that's not going to look good. something like that. And then like we have this here, maybe we can move it up a little bit. And maybe just there we go. So there's that, and then I have this circle here. And just soften some of this up just a little bit. And I'm just using my normal corner tools. And so if you hit the A for the white arrow tool, you can go in here and grab this and just sort of pull these back. That's what I'm doing here. All right, so I've got these three. So with the inside of my S and my O and my M, my O-R-R-I-S shape, we go into the Pathfinder and do minus front. Make sure that those were on top when you do that. That is how minus front works. And there's the first part of my signature. Now we go over here and do a little bit of work. And again, we go over here and release the compound shape. And first thing we want to do is get rid of the artifacts. There's an artifact. But this E is just looking really, something happened here, and I don't know what, but it just does not look the way it should. And like in my case, I'm just sort of modifying it all together. And even if you have to just kind of go in here and completely bang it up. And let's see what it looks like when we do the minus shape. Okay, so we have this compound shape, but even though we have the compound and we get kind of an idea what it looks like, you can still go in here and modify this a little bit with your white arrow tool. And there's that sliver over here again at the E where it's just a little too sharp for me. And so I'm just going in here with my corner tools and changing some of this slightly so it's not quite so sharp. It's got a little bit of a smoothness to it. Now we're over here at my B, and I'm just going to hit the minus because this sliver over here just kind of got out. And let's see, it's still kind of sharp over here. Oops. Okay. And there it is. There is my signature. Again, I apologize for my horrible handwriting. That is just where I'm at in this world. That is why I do vector art instead of written art and drawings and things like that. So that is how you can create a vector art signature. And thanks. And that is all for today. Thank you for watching.